Now we can learn to read. Be holy, so be holy. No more veil, no more boundary.
What can I lay my hands on today to succeed without suffering? Now, number one thing I want you to think about is, what is your definition of suffering? What do you mean by the word suffering? What many people are going through today is not suffering, but rather it is called sacrifice. But if you begin to see, or you continue to see, what you are going through as suffering, you may not succeed at all in what you do. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, what is suffering? When you are actually suffering, you are actually paying for your times of disobedience. You only suffer when you disobey. Suffering comes when you disobey. So take notes now. You are in primary school now. You have been asked to do your assignment. You refuse to do it. You went straight into the secondary school. You are given works to do, research works to do. You didn't do them. You are going to suffer. So whatever you will be going through after your secondary school or after your university, despite the fact that you finished school, if you are going through looking for jobs, trying to get job, no job, by here and there, you're running about, you are actually suffering at that time because you failed when you were laying your foundation. If you fail to lay a good foundation for yourself, you will suffer. That is the truth. You're going to suffer. But if you do not, if you obey instructions, you follow guidelines in your life, what you will be doing is sacrifice. Most of you are sacrificing today, but you are seeing it as suffering. Can I help you out now? If you have to carry your book and study over the night just because you're going to write an exam, that is not suffering. Don't see it as suffering. That is what sacrifice. And it is very necessary for you to do it. You must sacrifice so that you can enjoy later, so that you will not suffer later. So sacrifice, as I wrote here, is the payment for the success that you are going to enjoy later in the future. So there are two things that could happen to you. One thing is, you can make it now and suffer later, or sacrifice now and enjoy later. Two things. Make it now. There are some people that are making it now. Instead of them to be sacrificing, they are making it. Those are the people that can go into different kinds of illegitimate jobs or illegitimate businesses, like doing your Yahoo. That is what is rampant now. The females are also doing Yahoo, and if Yahoo is not working, they do Yahoo Plus, and if Yahoo Plus is not working, they do Yahoo Plus Plus. Instead of them to go and study C++ as a programming language, they study Yahoo++. So I tell you, you can get money today, you can make money today, but you're going to suffer for it tomorrow. Can I tell you something? You can be successful as a man doing illegitimate business, and you can train a lot of people into that kind of a business, and they'll be looking up to you and say, ah, this is the guy that taught me how to do Yahoo. This is the woman that taught me how to prostitute. This is the person that taught me this and taught me that. Hello, a day is coming that you will regret teaching somebody what is wrong. Why? Because money does not answer to everything. Money does not answer to everything. Money that you pursue illegitimately will fail you one day, and you will find yourself in trouble. And somebody that you have trained in that evil way will come back to you and say, man, you are the one that spoiled my life. Because it is not everybody that will go the same way that you went that will succeed the same way you have succeeded. Mind you, your own day of doom has not arrived. But the person that you train, the day of his or her doom can arrive earlier than your own. So therefore, that person will start giving you, he will start haunting your mind. Then you start feeling bad that, I'm the one who destroyed somebody's life. So even if you are going in the wrong way now, please don't train another person, so that you don't get doomed too quickly. Because the person can come back to you and kill you before your time, because you have destroyed that person's life. Now, if I need to go further, what are those things that you can do? How can you make it easily? Number one thing is this: nobody can give you money. Nobody will flush you or will rush money into your life or will flood money into your life if you are not useful for that person. Hello, am I speaking to somebody here? So collecting money from the rich will make you rich. If you want to be rich easily, you want to be rich quickly, make sure you find the problem to solve. Find a problem to what? To solve. If you don't find a problem to solve, then you can never succeed easily in life. And that's exactly what many youths are supposed to be doing today. You are in secondary school, you are in university. Look for problems. Before you choose a course, make sure you look for a problem that will make you choose that course of study. You don't just choose a course to study. You must identify a problem that you want to solve before you start sacrificing. Because if you make the wrong sacrifice, you will suffer. If you are making the wrong sacrifice, you will be suffering. But if you are making the right sacrifice, you are not going to be suffering. If you are studying the wrong course, you will see it as a suffering. Because the times that you are going to be stressing yourself studying, moving from one classroom to another, if you are sacrificing the wrong one, the wrong sacrifice, you will be seeing it as suffering. But if it is the right problem that you really want to solve, that you are approaching, that is what you are studying, you will not see that course of study as a suffering. Rather, you will see it as a sacrifice because you know where you are going. So before you choose any course of study, what problem do you want to solve? Who owns the problem? Who are those people passing through that problem? You can solve problems for the poor and you will be richer than them. Hello? The Bible says that from the hands of the poor, they will collect for those that even have more. Is that not what the Bible says? So if I look at this community and I see that they are very poor there, what is their problem? Food is their problem. Now, I want to satisfy the need of the poor in this community. Then I can easily go into a big farm. I can go into farming and look at, okay, what is it that they can buy cheaply in this community? And I have more than 500 people in this community. If I can farm tomatoes alone, and I'm able to supply it to the people of this community, you know I'm going to be richer than every one of them, and I'll become their king in that community. What have I done? I have solved the problem of what? Of feeding for them, for the poor. Now, if I now step ahead and I move to the rich people, what is the problem of the rich people? Then I can solve their problem as well. So if I see that the problem of this community is food, I can decide that I want to go and study agriculture in the university. That makes sense to me. Why? Because I want to solve the problem. Now, if I'm studying agriculture in the school, and during the practical times, they now took us to the farm, and I have to use the hoe to begin to make ridges. Is that suffering? That's not suffering, that's sacrifice. I am paying a sacrifice for a future that I have pursued. And that is the way, another way to choose a course of study. For many of you that have been asking me, I don't know the course to study in the university. Look for a problem and desire to solve that problem, then you get a course to study. Praise the name of the Lord. Are you still there with me? So your ability to solve a problem is very, very important to anybody beside you right now. There's somebody sitting beside you. The ability to solve that person's problem is very, very important. If you can identify that person's problem, then you are going to be rich easily in life. It's very, very easy to be successful in life once you are able to identify their problem. So now, you must identify the main problem of the rich, solve it, and get paid heavily. If you identify their problem, you will solve it and get paid. Now, how do you identify the problem? How do you know that a rich man has a problem? How do you know that a poor man has a problem? You must look for their pain. What is paining them? What is always on their heart? What they complain about too much? That is how to know that they have a problem. Don't just laugh at their problem. Don't just laugh at them and say, this one, you don't know what you are doing. And you keep laughing at them. No, see it as their problem and begin to think, how can I help these people out? In this community, there is no hospital. There is no hospital. No, that we have just few hospitals in this country. You can desire to go and study nursing just because you want to solve the problem of hospitals in this country. Many people are still using apps. Many people are still depending on counting shots that they give to them from different places. They don't even know what they are doing. So you can decide to go and study nursing. You can decide to go and enroll and become a nurse, an auxiliary nurse, and you become a help to the people in this community. Praise the name of the Lord. And you know, you make it easily. So identify their pains, identify the obstacle of the rich. What is blocking them from making more money? Identify their problem. Look deep into their life and see what is it that is obstructing their journey. Every rich man wants to be richer. So what is it that is not making that man richer? Once you are able to identify that problem and you begin to work towards it, and you get a solution to the problem of that man, there is no rich man that will see that you have a solution to his problem that will not hold you. I'm telling you the truth. Once they see that the solution is in your hand, they bring you in. They can spend their last card and invest it into your life. I've seen people that have been sponsored into an institution free just because they have solutions that they want to provide to a problem. So that is one of the things that you need to work into. So help them reach their desired destination. Every man wants a destination. Ask somebody beside you, where are you going? I want to help you. Tell that person, where are you going?
I
want to help you.
I want to help you.
Now you now tell that person, will you pay me?
Sure,
I will pay you. You can help me to where I'm going. If I want to go to Yanogo from here now, will I trek here?
Can I trek
down to Yanogo? Is it going to be easy for me? It's not going to be easy. But if somebody comes and says, this is bike, I want to meet you from here down to Yanogo, but you are going to pay me 100 naira, will I not give it to that person willingly? I will. Because he has offered me what I cannot give out or what I cannot do for myself. So he has solved my problem and therefore I have to pay that person. He gets to Yanogo, picks up another person again. He gets back again, picks up another person again. Within one day, he solved the problem of many people that could have been stranded in their home and he has made up to 5,000 naira within the day. And you are sitting down here, you don't look for anybody's problem and you want money to come to you. Money will not come, but you will suffer. I pray you will not suffer in the name of Jesus. So, there are two elements in solving this equation. The pain that you will help them to escape from and the pleasure that they want to enjoy. The pleasure that they want to enjoy. You will see the video will continue to be rich. How many of you know the video yet? Don't pretend. You know him. I know he's the most popular hip-hop artist. And that's why I mentioned this. Because he recognized that everybody wants pleasure. He recognized that we are all having issues with pleasure. We all want to dance. Then he came up with the idea and he started the music industry, solving people's problems. Instead of you to be unhappy, he makes you happy all the time. So that is why you have to pay to enter his concert. You have to sponsor him. You have to buy his record. You have to download his music. And he's getting richer and richer every day. Please, you can open the river so that we can have presentation. Now that you know the main issue, you now understand there are many problems with the people, both the rich and the poor. Now, the greatest problem of every human being on earth is financial problem. Somebody say financial problem. Say it again, say financial problem. There is no man that does not have financial problems. Both the rich and the poor, they all have financial problems. So if you can solve the financial problem of the poor man as well as the rich man, you will be rich successfully. You will be rich easily on this earth. And that is why you see the pastors will continue to be rich and they will never lack. You know why? Because pastors know that the people are always depressed. That's the problem of church members, depression. From one problem to another, you have one problem, you can't solve it by yourself. And you have tried every means of solving the problem, you couldn't solve it. So the next thing is, pastor, where are you? And you call the pastor, you go to the pastor's office, or you attend the pastor's program, and he prays for you, and he encourages your heart. And you now step back into that business of yours, and you succeeded. What will happen to that pastor? You will come back and say, pastor, I want to appreciate you. I have seen people giving a pastor a key to a car. I have seen people bless a pastor with houses. So there are a lot of things that you can get even as you solve people's problems. Counselors, you can become a counselor and you solve people's problems and your life will not remain the same. So financial problem is one of the greatest problems. So every rich and poor have this kind of a problem and you have to solve it for them. Now, listen to me as I round up. There are four people to focus on in order to get rich in life. There are four people to focus on. Number one set of people is yourself. Say myself. Say myself. If you focus on yourself, it makes you have it easy to succeed in life. So train yourself and gain experience. Train yourself and gain experience on that problem that you want to solve. It is very, very important for you to train yourself. If you don't train yourself, you can't solve my problem. If you tell me that you can solve my problem, I want to see how far you can do it. What have you done before? Where are the samples of what you have done? If you tell me that my house is not beautiful, and I look at it myself and say, I want this house to look more beautiful. What can I do? What do I need? I need a painter. I need a designer, isn't it? So if you come to me, before I can give you that job, I want to see what you have done before. What experience do you have? What can you show for it? Then when you come back and you show me what you have done, all what you have done, if you charge me, if the cost of that job is 20,000 naira, for example, when I see your job, how beautiful is this, and I see your experience, and you tell me that you are going to collect 40,000 naira, you know I will pay you. Why? Because of the experience that I've seen in you, because of your expertise, I will pay you more. Even though I was thinking that it is 20,000 naira, even somebody has come to me and said I will collect 20,000 naira. It is possible, very, very possible. Especially those of you that are bidding for contracts, or that will be bidding for contracts. Whatever work you are doing, please make sure you get them recorded. Snap them and keep them for your record. Very, very important for your destiny. Once you can show that you have done it before, it makes it easy for you. So, in the contract, they were going to award a road network then, I think back in Nigeria, they were going to award a road for two companies. And this man of God, this man came to my pastor, pray that daddy, help me to pray that they can award this contract to him and things like that. And my pastor said, how long have you been in this business? The man said, I've been in this now for the past 20 years. Do you have anything to show for it? The man brought out his iPad. And he began to show all the roads that he has built, that he has worked. He has worked with Julius Bagda, and he was showing all the houses that he has built as well. We were looking and said, very beautiful, very fine. Everything was. My pastor just rose up and he said, I declare that the Lord Himself will bless the work of your hand. Go and collect that job. Yes, sir. He collected the job. He got the job. What motivated the pastor to speak was what he saw. Because you cannot just prophesy on nothing. You have to prophesy on something. He said, I will bless the work of your hand, not your empty hand. The works of your hand, that is what the Lord will bless. So, and if the work of your hand is no good, no blessing will come on it, there is no magic. Even when favor comes, it will not recognize you. In fact, you yourself will not recognize people when it comes. Because the work of your hand is not good. So, whatever your hand finds doing, make sure you do it well. If you need to acquire more knowledge, acquire, grow, and know more about what you know how to do. So it is very important to train yourself, and you must recognize the error that could occur in anything that you want to do in life. Study to the extent that you can create problems for problems. Hello? I so much love it when I hear the software programmers. When they produce a software, they will produce a virus. A virus that will corrupt that software, that will make you call them back that, my Windows is corrupt. They say, okay, don't worry. We have the antivirus that will cure your virus. That is it. And that's how they make money. I'm telling you, I'm not saying that you gotta be creating problems for people. Of course. Hallelujah. So, but what I'm trying to say in essence is, whatever you want to do in life, you must understand the error that can occur in that thing that you are doing. So that when error occurs, you'll not be stranded. Do you understand what I'm saying now? So that is exactly what I am saying. So you must know how to create problems and how to solve the problem. Number two set of people that you must focus on if you want to succeed in life easily is other people. Love other people. In fact, if you love people, it is people that you love that you will know their problem. And it is because you love them that you want solution for their problem. And that is how to do it. Very easy. You will get it right. So you must deliberately look for other people and use your training, use your expertise, use your knowledge, your understanding for them voluntarily first. You know, when talking about love, it is voluntary that you want to help. So you have to voluntarily help people, invest in people's life first. It is going to be added to your profile. Are you getting what I'm saying? So after you have shown love to somebody and you have invested in their life, then God will now push you, you move in. See, the people that you volunteer for today are the people that will recommend you for those that will take you tomorrow. That's the truth. If you don't volunteer, There is no way you can get to where you are going. Because every man needs recommendation. You want to get a job, somebody has to recommend you. If you are not recommended and you get that job, when you fail, you will easily fall. I'm telling you the truth. So that is why you need to look for people's problems, love them, solve their problems willingly. Number three set of people that you need to focus on as you aspire to succeed in life, having identified their problems, is to look for business people, business owners. Business owners, these ones are very rich, those that have their own personal business by themselves. If you can get those people and look for their problem and solve it for them, you will be rich. Are you still here with me? In the next few minutes, I'm going to finish now. You will be rich if you can look for business owners and solve their problem, especially their financial problem. You will be rich. So if you can help them reduce their expenses, reduce their risk of failing in their business, they will never let you go. That is why you will see in some schools, there are some teachers that the professors will not want them to go. Am I talking right, sir? There are some teachers, they are so valuable. To the extent that if the teacher says, I want to go, the provider will say, can I increase your salary so that you don't go? That's exactly what happened between Jacob and Laban. Jacob was going to go. Laban said, you are not going, I will increase your salary. Laban said, no, I am going. It's okay, don't worry. Whatever profit you make, we will divide it into two. Jacob said, no, I am still going. And God wants me to step out of the universe. So that is, those are the values that you begin to get. Once you are able to identify a business owner, before Jacob came, Laban was already in the business. And when he joined in, he used his expertise to invest in the business of Laban. And that business grew up so heavily that Laban could not let go, Jacob. Until you get to that level, you are not yet succeeding. Are you with me here today? Now, the final set of people that you can focus on to be rich easily in life is the government. Say the government. Say the government. You know that there is money in the government. A lot of money. In fact, in Nigerian government, lots of money. But can you solve Nigeria's problem? Do you know Nigeria's problem? Have you identified the problem of this country? If you can solve the problem of this country, you will be the richest in Nigeria. Dangote identified the problem of Nigeria since how many years that he started. He knew that Nigeria would become the poverty capital of the whole world. He knew. So he stepped into that vision right from onset that I'm going to solve the problem of what? Of food in this country. And he stepped into it. And today, he is rich. He is the richest in Africa just because he solved the problem of common what? Salt, cement, sugar. What other things does he produce? Spaghetti, noodles, semovita. You didn't know semovita is another pumpkin. So, lots of problems that is solved like that. And everybody today, you cannot do without touching Dangote's products in the day. Yes. No matter what you do, you take sugar. You take sugar, you eat bread. And before you take bread, they will just put sugar in that bread. So, look for people's problems and solve it. So, today, Dangote is in partnership with the government. The government cannot joke with Dangote's business. Because if Dangote should hold up today, Nigeria is in trouble. As well as other African countries that surround Nigeria, they depend on the product of Dangote to survive. And right now, Dangote has gone into refinery because he realized that Nigeria, our government, is not going to build any refinery that can work just because they want to keep investing money. So he identified that problem for Nigeria. He said he's going to build a refinery. And right now, the refinery is getting to completion. Very soon, Dangote will start producing petrol for the whole world. And it will never be poor in his life because he identified our problem and is investing in it. Do you know Nigeria's problem? Economic problem is in Nigeria. What can you produce to solve people's problems in this country? What can you produce? The government will not produce it, but you can produce it and you will ease the trouble of the government. Government cannot satisfy everybody. Government cannot meet all our needs. But can you help the government to meet the needs of the people? And the government is celebrating. That is why you will see today how much do we use to register a business in CAC, Corporate Affairs Commission. How much do we use? The list that you can register an enterprise for 5,000 naira and the government will recognize you. Nothing must happen to your business as long as you register it. That means you are partnering with the government you are helping the government to solve the problem of the country. So they will register you straight away. Some people have registered limited companies, some people have registered different kinds of organizations that the government has permitted. What have you registered? What will you register to solve the problem of this country at the long run? So you can do exports. Exporting of products that you produce. You might not even be the one that produced the product. You can identify a product that is needed elsewhere. Maybe in Turkey, that's needed in South Africa, that's needed in Ghana. You can export them when you package them very well. You're good to go. You get them out. And people will see it and say, oh, that's an Nigerian product. We are always importing in this country. How can you help this country to export so that this country too can have the country we allow you to export it? They will not block you from exporting anything good from this country, and you will make more money. In fact, people outside the country, they pay more than people in the country. I'm talking about the machines. Then, once you are legitimate and you are working, you are going to help this country and take it to the next level. And you can help this country as well in the area of security. If you don't know the problem of this country, we have economic problem, I mentioned that. We have security problem. How can you help this country in the area of security? Why don't you go into business of CCTV camera installation? Go and learn how to install CCTV camera and begin to install. Talk to the community. Please, sir, we want to secure this our environment. Can we install a CCTV camera? Let's talk to the landlord. You are helping the community because we don't have any policeman coming into this community every day to secure us. But if you have CCTV camera, you can invest in it, you can go and learn it and know it and know how to do it. Then we talk to the chairman and the landlords in the area. They come together and say, okay, let us have the CCTV camera and we can use it to secure ourselves in this community. What have you done? You have solved the problem of the government. And the community not going to pay you? They will rally hand and pay you. They will pay you. So look for the problem of this community. Look for the problem of your area. Look for the problem of the government and solve it, and you will be rich as easy as ever. Another problem we have in this country is electricity. Maybe you are not looking into that. What alternative way can we get? Can we use to have electricity? When I was coming down from the UK, I thought about like I said, come on, I cannot depend on this power supply that is being given through PACL. What can I do? Let me go into solar farms. And I learned how to produce solar. And immediately when I got back, I was able to set up my own solar by myself. And I solved the problem of electricity over time. So I can charge my phone at any time. I have a lot of people that come here. I've solved so many people's problems. If I've solved your problem when it comes to charging your phone.
Hallelujah.
Did I collect any money from you?
No.
But I will start collecting from you. Yes, I have invested in you. So tomorrow, if I have a very big farm, solar farm, and I ask you to start paying to charge your phone, to charge your laptop, I believe you will pay. Because I have invested in you. I have identified you. I know your problem. I know your problem is to charge your phone. And I have solved that problem for you. I can turn it to a business and I will make more money. And that's the truth. So you may not know, you may think maybe I don't know what I'm doing. I gave you the opportunity to charge. Keep charging. It's a business for me later. And I'll make more money from you. Because it's not going to be small, it's going to be big than before. We have gas. You can produce gas from waste. Go and go to the university, go online and study. How can I produce gas? Cooking gas, though. Instead of you going to go and be buying gas, you can produce gas by yourself. Are you aware about that? Fine students that are here, they are still not aware. Go and do your research. You can produce cooking gas. Even from the waste, we have a waste outside here where we are packing different kind of dust. Even your latrine can produce gas for you. A lot of things are happening. People are moving. Stand up, rise up, and look for solutions. The government cannot produce everything. Till 2023, they are still not going to be a stable power supply in Nigeria. In fact, in the next 10 years, I don't think it's even possible yet. No, it's because there's no foundation for it yet. When we are going to have stable electricity, all these cables, so many cables are going to be condemned. Because if you have stable electricity for three days, you will hear that your transformer has blown. What brings the transformer? It's outdated. They are outdated transformers that we are using, outdated cables that we are using. So one thing we are going to have for them, stable electricity, so many things will change. So many houses will be pulled down. Because there are locations, strategic locations that we can have our plants, where we can have these things that are talking about. So we are not yet there, and we are not thinking about it yet. Not yet. So solar farm is there to produce electricity when the time comes. So education is another problem of Nigeria. Why don't you study very hard and help people out, they will pay you. You know why government cannot stop private schools? Because they know they cannot satisfy every pupil and every student in this country. That is why private schools will continue to remain. And if you can do a private teacher, you can do a private tutor. If you are going to do it. You know how much private teachers are collecting when they train just one child? After school, they collect even more than their salary as a teacher. Am I lying, sir? No. They get more than their salary as a teacher when they do extra lessons. Calculate it. So you meet with people, if you are so brilliant and you are so good as a teacher, you will meet with parents that can pay you and they pay you more than the school that you are even working. So you are, what have you done? You have solved the problem of education in the country. So you are bringing out people from illiteracy and the government will be happy with you and you will make money easily. So, online training, you can train people online and solve people's problems. Now, the final one is religion. We have religion. Religion, what religion can do in this country is very, very important. If you so much love God, if you so much love God, and you do the things of God well, you can invest your life in the things of God. That does not stop your other career, but you can help people that are in depression. It helps many people that are rising up today, doing armed robbery, fornicating, prostitution, and all sorts of things like that. Many of them have been revived through the help of religious men, through the help of pastors, through the help of imams, you know, preaching to them, and fast, preaching to them, they have revived them. What have you done? You have helped the community. In a street, there is no thief in that street. Nobody is stealing. All the children, you talk to them, they begin to change. What have you done? You are helping that community. You are reviving that community. Even if you have a church, people will come to that church and they will invest in your vision as a pastor. And that is the final thing I'm going to tell you today. Thank you very much for the opportunity you have given to me. And I believe that if you can sit down and think on these things that you have just discussed, I believe that you will succeed easily without suffering in life. Don't forget that I have told you, when you suffer, it is as a result of your disobedience in the past. But right now, if you are doing anything, you are sacrificing. You are not suffering. God bless you. See you next time. Thank you for coming. And God bless you once again. Thank you very much. Peace and go. Now we can enter in dreams. Now we can enter in. Behold, these are the only.